All over the world, you will hear the sound of flutes. You'll hear them in China. You'll hear them in the woodlands. You'll hear them in South America. You hear them in Europe. You hear them in Ireland. Nobody knows where the first flute came from. But the Algonquin people of the Northeast have the best story of all. Long ago, there lived a boy who was in love with a beautiful girl. The custom among his people was that if you loved a girl, you would go and you would bring back a deer that you had killed, or a great basket of corn that you had grown, and you would set it on a blanket outside of the girl's wigwam, and you'd sit on the blanket. And if the girl wanted to marry you, she would come outside and sit on the blanket next to you. But this poor boy had nothing to bring. He couldn't hunt. When he shot an arrow, it would go zigzag. He was lucky he didn't shoot himself in the foot. And when he tried to grow corn, it grew and then it died right in front of him. What could he do? So he spread his blanket in front of the girl's wigwam and did the one thing he knew how to do. He said, "I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you, I love you, I love you. I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. I love you. I love you, I love you, I love you. I love you, I love you, I love you." Well, this was beginning to drive the girl and her parents crazy. And one day, the girl's parents said to her, "Either you tell that boy that you will marry him, or you tell him to go away. He is driving us insane." So she walked outside. She looked down at the boy. He looked up at her. He said, "I love you, I love you." She said, "I know." "Well, will you marry me?" She says, "I may marry you if you can bring me..." She did like this boy. He was very, very handsome. He seemed bright. But how would she know if he could make a good husband? "If you will bring me a special gift..." "Oh, I'll bring you anything, 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 anything." "I will marry you if you can bring me a gift that is as strong as a cedar, as beautiful as a bird, as free as the wind, and has music of the heart." "You want something that's strong as a cedar, beautiful as a bird, free as the wind, has music of the heart. Okay, I'll get that for you." And off he went. The boy sat down in the woods to think. Now, he had no idea how he was going to get something that was as strong as a cedar, as beautiful as a bird, as free as the wind, and had music of the heart. And so he told his troubles to the wind. He told his troubles to the brook. He told his troubles to the sky. And as he sat there, the wind started to blow. And suddenly there was a thunk, and a tree limb had fallen right by his side. He looked down. It was cedar. He was sitting underneath a cedar tree. He got his tools and he shined up that stick till it was gleaming in the sun. And then he ran back to the girl's wigwam and he sat down on his blanket and he shouted, "I did it! I 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 did it!" And she came out and he held up the stick. She says, "Oh, well, that's a very pretty stick." "Yes, it is. But Is it as beautiful as a bird? No. Well, is it as free as the wind? No. Well, does it have music in it? I don't think so. Well, you're going to have to work a little harder on that. And she went back inside. Well, the boy went back to the woods and he sat down. He told his trouble to the trees and he told his trouble to the wind and he told his troubles to the brook and to the birds. And as he sat there, two beautiful bluebirds flew by and dropped two beautiful feathers right by his feet. He looked at the feathers. He looked at the stick. And he had a wonderful idea. He tied the feathers onto the stick, and then he carved the most beautiful shapes of feathers onto his stick, and he ran back to the girl, and he sat down on the blanket, and he said, I did it. Well, she came outside, and she looked. Well, she said, that is pretty. Look at all those beautiful carvings. Oh, and tying those feathers on. Very nice. But is it as free as the wind? No. Well, does it have any music in it? I don't think so. Well, you better go back and work on it. But it's coming! And so the boy went back to the woods, and he sat under the tree. It was getting late now. And he told his trouble to the brook, and he told his trouble to the wind, and he told his trouble to the trees. And the trees began to whisper. The boy almost fell asleep. He could hear their whispering deep inside. It was almost like whispering and speaking to him. And suddenly, he had an idea. He ran back to his wigwam, he got his tools, and he bored a hole through the stick from one end to the other. And then he ran back to the girl's wigwam and he sat on a blanket, I did it. She came out. Look at that. Put it to your ear. And she did. She put the end of the stick to her ear. And sure enough, through the stick came the sound of the wind. She looked at the boy. You are amazing.
Thanks.
Well, does it have music in it? I forgot about that. Well, if you can get music in this, I would marry you. Well, he ran back to the forest. He told his trouble to the brook and to the trees and to the wind and to the birds. But it was late, and he fell asleep. And as he slept, all of the creatures began to speak to one another, which is what they do when people aren't listening. They had no idea how to put music in a stick. The brook laughed at them.
Blip, 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 impossible. Blip, blip, blip. No one could do it.
Even the wind didn't know it. And one tiny voice rang out.
I can do it. I can do it.
They looked up. Who was that?
I can do it. I can do it.
It was Woodpecker.
The brook laughed. Bloop, 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 bloop. Woodpecker. Bloop, 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 bloop. What do you know about music? Bloop, 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 bloop. All you do is go peck, 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 peck.
I can do it.
And so, that night, the woodpecker did it. All night he worked on that stick. And when morning came, the boy looked down and his stick was different. There were 7 holes drilled into the stick, holes that hadn't been there before. Now, 7 is a very important number to native people in the Americas, because there are 7 directions. There's north, there's south, there's east, there's west. But there is also up, and there is also down. And most important of all, there is the direction where you always are, the center. The boy looked at this stick with 7 holes in it. He looked up at the bird. And then he took the stick and he put it in his mouth and he began to blow. A sound came out. Three notes! And then he saw the woodpecker staring at him, and he understood. And to thank the woodpecker, he tied a special little piece onto the stick. It's a piece that you will find on Native American flutes to this day. It's called the bird, and it's the shape of the woodpecker's bill. And then he ran back as fast as he could to the girl's wigwam. This time he didn't say a word. He sat down on the blanket and began to play. Without a word, the girl stepped from her wigwam and sat down next to the boy, because she knew she could spend the rest of her life listening to this music that came from the heart.